Hello and welcome back for a new episode of Red Dead Redemption 2, and in this we follow Jack's life because Arthur is freaking dead. This is Late Monkey Gaming and let's go.
We brought that trouble on ourselves.
By we, you mean me.
The one me who went and shot him.
Seems like he deserved shooting.
I'm sure he did. But I've been thinking, ain't it about time you stop being the man making them decisions?
I'm trying.
Art?
I think so.
Is that it with you? Tahiti or killing? Come on, John. Please, try.
Try what?
We gotta live somewhere for more than just a few weeks.
Okay. Let's see. We can find it. In strawberry. What do you know about strawberry?
I know that, like, good, honest, hardworking men a whole lot more than angry killers. So make yourself good and honest.
I'm always honest. But not always good. I'm always honest.
My whole life I've been surrounded by fools with moral codes. Here's a moral code. Look out for folks. Stop trying to act like some hero in a book.
You know about heroes in books.
My reading's getting pretty good.
I read different books then.
The books is Jack's. And well, maybe he's doing most of the reading, but still.
You're a bad influence on your mother.
Arthur. Okay, this is, after all that action, this is a tad bit weird, but you know, I dig it.
Okay.
Okay. Don't tell me Abigail is gonna be a nurse.
Thank you, Doctor. Hey, how you getting on?
I found some work.
Me too.
Delivering goods out to some ranch.
Cleaning a doctor's surgery.
Fine living.
It is, John. It is. This is the way to it.
Take your word on that. What do you suggest now?
I'll stay here. Get on with the work. You deliver them goods and then collect me.
Okay.
And John, I love you. Don't you forget that. I love you.
The kids got some age issues, evidently. Okay. Really, I have nothing. And $11, where the heck is all the money that Arthur gave? Oh, I think Arthur might have given it all to Tilly. Wait, seriously? They had all that money? The one that Tilly was left with, and you know, where is all that money? Strange. See the map, we are in Strawberry, right? And we are not wanted anywhere except this place, which is fine. Let's remove this, it's annoying. Nice, man. It feels good to not be wanted. Oh god, holy shit. We may have dropped our shit. Something fall off. I think something fell off. We should really have driven carefully, it seems. Oh well. Time to drive it carefully now. How far is it? Are we any closer? We all the way there. Oh my god, really? Let's drive slow then. Gotta be careful. Can't have any more things falling off. Why do I get the feeling that we'll end up owning that place? I have this weird feeling that we'll end up owning that place. Could be wrong. Could be wrong. But why not? Strawberry sounds like a good place to live, quite honestly. Okay.
Mr. Geddes?
No, sir. Mr. Dickens is overseer.
Jim Milton, I'm delivering some supplies from the store in Strawberry.
Okay.
This is quite a place.
Yes, it's beautiful.
Send everything?
Yeah, I think so.
So, partner, you looking for hands?
Why? You looking for work?
Yeah. My wife, she was in business with her family, and turns out it's a long story.
Yeah, I don't know. Married hands. It's a lot. Of
I'm a good worker. My wife, Agatha, you're a boy. Lancelot, you're all of them.
Big man around, boy? The hell out of here. Now, that ain't very neighborly. Threatening us is neighborly. Hey, mind if I enjoy one of these apples? Put that down. Delicious. Oh, when's Boss Man gonna sell this place, boy? I don't think there's any plans for that. You boys want a drink? It's some fine scotch whiskey. Put that down. Put that down. These supplies for the season. Get off the farm. Come on. We know that we're not wrong. Get down from there. Bye, bud.
Come back here.
You can use that horse. And don't get yourself hurt.
Whoa, I keep using the wrong button. I keep using the button that makes you jump out of the horse.
Hey, this is your last chance to come out of this
That was easy. I thought I had to beat them up.
Thank you. Milton, isn't it? Those boys are out of Laramie. Work for Mr. Avery. Thank you.
Don't mention it. Listen, I ain't looking for no charity or nothing, but I'm serious. You got work? We'll work. We got robbed ourselves a few days back.
We ain't got married hands here. You're married.
Look harder than any one of them. Real honest, my wife, even though she's got fancy thoughts, Sure work.
Seem kind of desperate. Trouble you in?
No trouble, sir. Aside from my brother. He tricked us and robbed her of her inheritance. Good people. Good work. Even Lancelot.
What does Mr. Geddes need with a boy? Just another mouth to feed.
Just please give us a chance. I can handle myself okay. You know that already.
Yeah. Makes me wonder just who would have robbed you. But give you a chance. I'll let Mr. Geddes know when him and his wife return.
Thank you, Mr. Dickens. I'll go get my wife.
No, you stay here. It's getting late. We'll go get her and Strawberry. We'll bring her here tomorrow. Hold you around in case any more of them Laramie boys turns up. There's a little cabin out yonder past the ranch house. If things work out, y'all can stay there.
Thank you. You'll not regret this.
Yep. Get yourself settled. I'll have work for you tomorrow when Mr. Geddes returns.
Well, that was simple. All right, guys, this is that's it for this episode. I'll see you around in the next to continue the boring life of John. All right. On that note, this is Late Monkey Gaming, signing off. Bye-bye.